In this video, I'll be introducing the concept of metric prefixes. Watching this video is one step toward meeting the learning objective of applying prefix multipliers to convert units. You may be familiar with using conversion factors in your everyday life. If a recipe needs 6 eggs, you will think to yourself, oh, that's half a dozen eggs. You know that half a dozen is equal to 6 because 1 dozen eggs equals 12. So the mental math you did was divide 12 by 2 to get 6, which you converted to half a dozen. Unit conversions are also helpful in Chem 1A, other fields of science, and engineering. One way to think about unit conversions are dominoes. Here's an example where you see a domino, which is here just used as an example of a fraction, and each domino has a numerator and denominator. The numerator, the case of a unit conversion, will cancel if it also appears in the denominator of a different domino. This results in an end unit when the fractions are multiplied that has any remaining uncanceled units. In this case, we get 3 dots over a blank spot. This can be applied for multiple step conversions, where we'll apply the same logic. Any unit that appears in both the numerator and denominator will get canceled out by one another. That happens in this case to the 5 dots and the 4 dots. We're left with 3 dots in the numerator of one domino and 1 in the denominator of another, giving us a unit of 3/1. Here's another example where we have 2 dots canceling in the numerator and denominator, 5 dots and 4 dots, giving us a remaining unit of 6 dots and a blank spot, and that's our resulting unit. We'll talk more about how to apply this strategy to the learning objective after introducing the metric system. The metric system is the common language of scientific measurement. It's employed by all countries in the world, except 3. There are 6 different prefixes that we want you to know in Chem 1A, though numerous other powers of 10 exist. These 6 prefixes are kilo, symbol K, deci, symbol D, centi, symbol C, milli, symbol M, micro, symbol mu, which is a Greek letter, nano, symbol N. They have different multipliers and exponential forms, which will be discussed in the following examples. You should memorize these through either flashcards or simply by doing lots of practice problems, as this is the best way to become familiar with unit conversions. The common units we'll use in Chem 1A are length, time, and mass. Prefixes can be applied to all of these measured quantities. For example, the prefix kilo, we can describe length, 1 kilometer, otherwise known as a kilometer, is equal to 1,000 meters. In the exponential form, this is equal to 10 to the third meters. For time, a kilosecond is equal to 1,000 seconds, or 10 to the 3 seconds. For mass, a kilogram is equal to 1,000 grams, or 10 to the 3 grams. Let's put this to the test. If a gold coin weighs 125 grams, what is its weight in kilograms? Using the example of the domino, we have numerators and denominators for each step in our conversion. Here, the given information goes first, which is 125 grams. You'll notice there's nothing in the denominator because the unit gram is by itself. When we convert, we apply the conversion factor shown here. 1 kilogram is equal to 1,000 grams. You'll notice gram is on the bottom so as to cancel with the numerator of the first domino. Gram cancels with gram and we're left with a kilogram as our top unit, which is what we need to solve this problem. When typing this into your calculator, you'll divide 125 by 1,000. This gives an answer of 0.125 kilograms. For conversion factors smaller than the base unit, this can be a little bit more complex to conceptualize. What the multiplier means here is there's a very small number of the base unit in this particular prefix. So this tells us that there's 0.000001 meters in a micrometer. That's shown here in this first conversion. Another way to think about this that can be easier to conceptualize is to think about how many times the small unit fits in the base unit. In this case, the small unit is micro. So in the case of length, we would have 10 to the sixth micrometers is equal to 1 meter. These are saying the exact same thing, but the first case is saying how many times does the base unit fit in the small unit, and it's a very small number of times. Or said another way, how many of the small unit fit into the base unit? These can be expressed as fractions as well. 10 to the negative 6 meters is equivalent to 1 micrometer, or 1 meter is equivalent to 10 to the 6 micrometers. Again, these are completely equivalent mathematically, and you can choose to use whichever one makes more sense to you. Let's solve a problem where we convert 62 micrometers to meters. We take our unit given information with the unit, and we know that we need micrometers on the bottom in the denominator to cancel the micrometers in the numerator. I'm going to use the conversion factor on the right. There are 10 to the 6 micrometers in 1 meter. Micrometers cancels, and then we should be left with our unit of meters. When we do this in our calculator, we can divide 62 by 10 to the 6th. This gives us an answer of 6.2 times 10 to the negative 5th meters. This makes sense because the human hair, if you think about a human hair relative to the length of a meter stick, a human hair is a very, very small number of meters. It's super tiny. This negative exponent indicates this type of relationship. We can also apply multiple conversion factors in a single problem. We'll practice that using milli as one of the prefixes and kilo that we talked about earlier. What we know from the table is that 1 millisecond is equal to 10 to the negative 3rd seconds. Said another way, in 1 second, there are 10 to the 3rd milliseconds, because again, milliseconds is the smaller unit. To convert this quantity, 3.2 meters per second, to kilometers per millisecond, we need to convert both the length component from meters to kilometers and the time component from seconds to milliseconds. I rewrote the given information here as a fraction. The velocity given is 3.2 meters per second. Per second implies that the runner will travel 3.2 meters in 1 second. That's why I put the 1 in parentheses, because it's implied. Then to convert from meters to kilometers, first to the length unit, we're going to put meters in the denominator so that they'll cancel with the meters in the numerator of the first domino, or the given information. But you'll remember from a few examples ago that 1 kilometer is equal to 1,000 meters. That's where I got this information. Now, if I were to just do this calculation, I would be left with units of kilometers per second, which is not quite what we need. We need kilometers per millisecond. So taking it one step further, I know that there are, in 1 second, 1,000 milliseconds, otherwise known as 10 to the third. That's just the exponential form. I put seconds on the top in the numerator because I need seconds to cancel so that I'm left with milliseconds in the denominator and kilometers in the numerator, which is what I need. When I did this problem, I got 3.2 times 10 to the negative 6 kilometers per millisecond. And I did that by dividing 3.2 by 1,000 and then dividing it by 1,000 again. You can also divide by 3.2 by 1,000 squared, but just be sure to carefully use your parentheses. Now that you've watched this video, you have the first steps required to apply prefix multipliers to convert units. The best way to learn this content, and lots of other content in Chem 1A, is to practice, practice, practice. Find practice problems in the book, rework the examples shown in this video, and use other sources on other types of course materials to get practice. Thanks for watching.